God, calling the oppressed. O ye heavy laden, come to me and rest. Come no longer tarry, I your load will bear. Bring me every burden, bring me every care. Come and trust my mind. Come, my yoke is easy and my burden's disappointed, wandering here and there, dragging chains of doubt and loaded down with care. Do unholy feelings struggle in your breast? Bring your case to Jesus, He will give you rest. To me, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Hear me and be blessed. Oh, yes. Meek and lowly, come and trust my mind. Come, my yoke is easy and my burden's light. Have you by temptations often conquered been? Has a sense of weakness at times brought distress within? But let me tell you today, Jesus will sanctify you if you'll claim His best. Oh yeah. In the Holy Spirit, He will give you rest. Come unto me. I can hear Him say now, I am meek and lowly. Come and trust my might. Come,
Hallelujah. Oh, Hallelujah. Oye tumira na ne dini afa ani omega. Oye wajin se obesum no woni kromu yi. Orange o mode biarada. Asan se we dada nyangupon. Amen. My original and I so. Ebraya bompa jae adina sias ma nyangupon. Osanasi no fata ayeyi. I want no, not do maracon at Yassi. And you are holding your to me, and you are sicker, and you are half fair. So what you are saying, a rad in a wire.
Oh, yeah, my home, yeah, more. What for radie, Sammy Fran. papa odi urada ada yakutsamni yaba kasi asira re asira ninaya mi bo santi yami ayeye nina ya odi odi sa maku chamni baba kasi
Jesus, that was a kung fu erati. What do you do so, my? Why young on my erati? Oh, what's it daura? That was your mouth so erati. Oya kasi, wadomo ndo sumaye dodo.
Jesus, ya baka ni awayati.
Oh,
Jesus, ya babo. Yako chamni yaba kasi ni
yadawasi osiro hini yadawasi enyonyamura yadawasi obutantim. What the mundo suma yedudo eradi? Ade na enka enanyi mrefoi. Yashe ni awa yama ya. Ade na ensi eradi. Yampa ebano nyinani eradi edawasi. Enanyi mrefoi ye yiwa ya kamfudi. Uye kasi na uburu ajini nasu. Se yeti ya sena ye uradi ye wadum. Edawasi. Yama usu. Ye kutu sorry ho. Adomora, what dominanti? Amen. Amen. Bon sam sendi yam. Hallelujah.
We are together again, just praising the Lord. We are together again. With one accord, something good is going to happen. Something good is in stock. We are together again. Just praising the Lord. We are together again. We are together. Oh. Just praising the Lord. We are together again. With one accord. Something good is going to happen. Something good is in store. We are together again. Just praising the Lord. Oh, something good is going to happen. Something good is in store. We are together again. just praising the Lord. We will celebrate our God. We will celebrate our God. And His banner be raised, and His glory be seen. We will celebrate our God. And His banner be raised, and His glory be seen. We will celebrate our God. We will celebrate our God. Oh, we will celebrate our Lord. Let His banner be raised, and His glory be seen. We will celebrate our God. Let His banner be raised, and His glory be seen. We will celebrate our God. Behold, I am the Lord, the God of flesh. Is there anything? Is there anything God for Him? Oh, behold, I am the Lord, the God of flesh. Is there anything? Is there anything God for Him? Is there anything too hard for Him? Is there anything? Is there anything too hard for Him? He got the whole world in His hand. 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 Oh, humble yourself before the Lord. He will lift you up. Hallelujah. Humble yourself before the Lord. He will lift you up. 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 Hallelujah, humble yourself before the Lord. He will lift you. He will lift you up. 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 Hallelujah, humble yourself before the Lord. He will lift you up. Great things He has done, greater things He will do. Be the glory, great things He has done. Oh, great things He has done, greater things He will do. Be the glory, great is He has done. Oh, I feed the baby, I feed the baby. Oh, yaminisa wa masu idie, I feed the baby. Onya minisa wa masu idie, afidie beye. O kunim, o
Oh, Atia Sifanai,
Alléluia.
Atia sifona.
Ni pani fodia nuna. Kutu sari.
To the house of the Lord.
The glory of
welcome
the
somebody
Lord.
To the house of the Lord tonight.
Of the Lord.
Oh, I can see you.
I can see you. The glory of the Lord. I love you with the love of the Lord.
I can see you.
I can see.
I can. I
the glory of the Lord. I love you with the love of the Lord.
Oh, I can see you.
I can see you. The glory of the Lord.
Let's give it out to the Lord.
I love you.
Amen and amen. Amen and amen. Amen and amen. 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 Amen and amen.
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 God richly bless you for coming to church.
Amen.
God richly bless you for coming to church tonight.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, the world is in a very chaotic condition, but if you've made it to the presence of God, God richly bless you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
And I was just thinking this morning, I was just trying to go over what was going on in Israel.
And then now, the echoes were Israel, they say, no.
And I tried researching, you know, the number of times Israel has been to war.
No, yeah, you should move far and pen. Do Israel.
And I realized that in the history of Israel, since it became a country, an independent country,
no, who say Israel, be your man, didn't know, no, na bakose mo.
They've had, they fought about 6 to 8 wars.
Wa kun be your impens, ya kosi impen wa kiso.
And in all these wars,
na kuni na mo,
they have emerged victorious.
Ni na mo.
So if physical Israel is winning her battles, spiritual Israel is winning her battles. Oh, hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
So I have this confidence. The prophet told us that if you want to know God's timepiece, look at Israel.
Israel.
And to have, you know, the enemies attack them on a Sabbath day. When the enemy knows they can't really do anything. That is what the enemy also does to us. When you are enjoying yourself in the Lord, that is when he comes. But despite all this, The battle is the Lord's. Oh, praise the Lord, somebody.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
So God richly bless you tonight. Amen.
Amen.
So if he who watches over Israel is watching physical Israel,
then
the spiritual Israel is also in his mind.
Praise
the Lord.
Amen.
Let's turn our Bibles to the book of 1 Kings. Before we begin, I want to thank our pastor. I'm sure he's online watching. And I want to thank all those who are online viewing. God richly bless you. And for you who is also here too, God bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 1. I want to read verse
4.
Then they brought up the ark of the Lord, the tabernacle of meeting, and the holy furnishings that were in the tabernacle. The priests and the Levites brought them up. Also King Solomon and the congregation of Israel were assembled with him, were with him before the ark, sacrificing sheep and oxen, that they may not be counted or numbered in the ark of the covenant of the Lord to his place, into the inner sanctuary of the temple, cherubims, for the cherubims spread their wings over the place of the ark, and the cherubim overshadowed the ark and its poles.
Amen.
And the poles extended to the poles extended so that the end of the poles could be seen from the holy place in front of the inner sanctuary. Amen. And it came to pass, let's jump to 10. And it came to pass when the priest came out of the holy place,
amen,
that the cloud filled the house of the
amen.
Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hebrews chapter 9, verse 11 to 15. Hebrews 9, 11 to 15. But Christ came as high priest of good things to come, that with with the greater and more perfect tabernacle, not made with hands,
amen,
that is not of this creation, not with the blood of goats and cows, but with his own blood he entered the most holy place once and for all,
amen,
having obtained eternal redemption. For the blood of bulls and goats and the ashes of a heifer, sprinkling the unclean, sanctifies for the purifying of the flesh. How much more shall the blood of Christ, who through eternal spirit offered himself without spot to God, cleanse your conscience from the dead works to serve the living God? And for this reason, he is the mediator of the new covenant.
Amen.
By means of death, the redemption of transgressions unto the first covenant, that those who are called may receive the promise of eternal inheritance.
Amen.
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 Amen. May the Lord add his blessing to the reading of his word. Let's pray. Father, we thank you. We bless your holy name. We've come before your throne. And Father, we are asking you, God, come and inspire these words, O God, and let it be living in our lives. That when it's time, O God, give us the grace to be able to lay our hearts out before you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Come and take over, God, and let this word direct the word to the place you want it to go, O God. And Father, at the end of the day, let it be said like the two men from Emmaus, did not our hearts burn within us as you expounded the scriptures on our way? We bless your holy name in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We may please be seated in heavenly places.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God richly bless you all. Amen and amen.
Amen.
So tonight we just want to look at the ark in position. The ark in position. So we know the ark. We've heard of the ark. And so when we look at the book of Exodus chapter 25, that God commanded Moses to build an ark from the acacia wood. And God gave the strict measurements for that ark. And that ark should be built with wood. But then he should overlay it with gold. And the prophet tells us that wood is humanity. And the gold is deity. So the wood being laid with gold means that humanity and deity have come together. Oh, praise the Lord.
Amen.
It means that the mighty God has come down in flesh. God in Christ has come to the earth. And today we can also say, Christ in the bride. Oh, praise God.
Amen.
So you may be a normal wood walking on the earth. You are not that special. But what makes you special is the gold, the deity that has come down. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
So I can say this evening, deity is not in heaven. Deity is not anywhere. Deity is in you. Deity sits in the bride. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Deity can be found where the redeemed is. Where a part of God can be found. Can be found where the body of Christ is. Which is in the bride. The body of Christ is not one man church. But it is the elect of God from all over the world. Oh, praise the Lord.
Amen.
And the feet of this ark was even gold.
And
inside and outside the ark was gold. So we can say you have deity inside and outside of you. You walk to places and people are angry when you walk there. You don't understand why. The he that is in you is greater than the spirit out there. When you enter into places, you cause a confusion amongst the children of the enemy. It is no fault of yours, because it is deity sitting inside of you. Oh, can I hear him?
Amen. Amen.
Now these two gold cherubims that are were sitting on the ark.
Now cherubim mieni above mieni anu wati apama da kanusu ono.
They have spread their wings over the top of the ark.
No adu wanta ba akata nusuru.
And in the middle of the top of the ark,
was
the mercy seat. If there was where the blood was sprinkled for atonement, so the priest first atones for himself. He first atones for himself. Then he atones for the people. Meaning that without the mercy seat, there is no mercy for anybody. Without the mercy seat, there is no atonement for
Israel.
The ark of God was a proof that God was with them. Oh, praise the Lord.
Amen.
And therefore, it is a reminder to us that God is in our midst. Oh, I say God is in our midst.
Amen.
The word of God today, the message of the hour, should remind you he is here.
Oh, Wahabi. Amen. Amen.
They had the prophet.
No, therefore,
who received the instructions to build the ark. But remember, the ark was not carried by the prophet, it was carried by the priest. So even when the prophet left, the Levites were still in position. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
The prophet may be gone, but there are Levites in this house who are still carrying up the words. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Levites cannot go outside what the prophet has said.
Now, let with one, they want me in video. This one I can ask
with or without the prophet.
So this one will hold, only hold.
The ark of the covenant is still being carried on.
What? That's so cream.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
The owner of the ark. is still here. That is why in Joshua chapter 3, verse 15, even when Moses was gone, and they go to the Jordan River, and the Levites stepped into the Jordan with the ark, the Jordan was overflowing, but with the ark of the covenant with them, immediately they stepped into the water, you begin to pave way. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
And there are Levites in this house who will lift up the word of God. Oh, my brother, we are lifting up the word of God. And wherever you go, situations will give way.
Amen. Amen.
It doesn't matter the age of the Levites. Once they have been ordained to carry the word, in the face of criticisms, in the face of all what people can say, in the face of situations, we are still carrying the word of God. The word, the ark is always in its position. Where is it? It is leading the people. It means that wherever the ark goes, the people went.
Amen.
Joshua told the people,
Joshua, catch your word.
Sanctify yourself this day.
And
I can also tell you tonight, sanctify yourself this day.
Amen.
God is about to do something in our lives. We keep seeing it. If you have not seen anything for the past 4 weeks in this house, the Lord keeps coming to visit us. The Lord will continue doing it. Don't lose faith in the situation. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
We have the ark of the covenant in our midst. Church of the living God, sanctify yourself.
Amen.
The prophet said, if you put the word of God first, you are about to come out right. Follow the ark while the Levites are carrying it. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Move at the rhythm of the ark.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
The ark will take care of itself. You don't need to prop up the ark. Even if the Levites who are holding the ark fail, God will raise up people to hold the ark. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
And with the ark, which is the presence of God, things will fall into his place. If the ark must find its place, situations will also find their place.
Amen.
When Israel crossed the Jordan, Joshua lifted up his eyes.
Joshua man in Israel.
And you saw a man there with a sword.
Ah, okay, granted.
Then you went to him.
Now,
he said, are you for us?
I said, no, come here now.
Or you are with the enemy.
And
you told him,
no, catch
him, I am your boss.
Me,
the work you are carrying.
Amen.
The work you are carrying now. Me, I gave it to you.
Me,
I am the captain of the host of Israel.
Amen.
My brother, my sister.
Amen.
The captain of the host of Israel is standing right in front of you with the drawn sword. What is that sword? The king's sword. Not anybody's sword. But the king's sword.
Amen. Amen.
What was he there to do?
He
came to check on his people. For the past 4 weeks,
amen.
God has been coming by to check upon
us.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
And as Israel crossed the Jordan and drew closer to Jericho. Jericho was on a lockdown. Just by the mere fact that they have heard, they have not seen. They have only heard that Israel is conquering other people. Does it surprise you that somebody who you don't know has heard so much about you and is not the best? And funny enough, they will not come and ask you whether it's true or not. For the fear of you, people are beginning to talk. That is what happened to Jericho. The prophet said, God, the fear of God went ahead of Israel.
Amen.
Everybody was indoors.
No, be asked them.
But remember, walls built by man can be broken by God.
Amen. First of all, didn't pass out to the bed, never break with him.
And walls built by God cannot be broken by man.
Amen.
Their walls are not obstacles.
First of all, and you can see deal.
They are only stepping stones. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Your walls are not obstacles.
First of all, and you can see
they are stepping stones.
Amen.
People want to limit God with your doctrines and your creeds. No. Nowadays, when you talk to believers, we are not seeing the power of God. And we are not seeing the power of God.
So when you did one come out, they walk and say, "Well, when you go to me,
you see signs and wonders." If you want to see signs and wonders, change your atmosphere.
Amen.
Change your atmosphere. You are not seeing signs and wonders because of where you are sitting. Change your location. Because believe you me, the power of God is moving in the midst of the bride. The power of God is moving in the midst of the bride.
Amen.
So I can say, thus says the Lord,
said,
the move is on for the bride.
Amen.
The move is on for the bride. So when you look, what do you see? What are you looking for? As for me, I can see God moving. It depends on what you are looking at. It depends on where you are and what you are looking at. But I am in the presence of God looking at the promise. Oh, hallelujah. Amen, amen and amen. Amen. You want a revival? There is a revival going on. You don't have to. The revival is not a place. No. It is the Spirit of God moving in the church. So then you become the revival. In the Welsh revival.
Amen.
In the Welsh revival. When the a policeman went to Wales to find out what was the revival all about.
Wales in Kenya now. Police no call house or question said in Kenya no see corner.
He said, "I've heard so much. What is going on? Where is it taking place?" And he met another policeman on the street. And he asked him, "Where is the revival?" He says, "The revival is not somewhere. I am the revival. Oh, you are the bride's revival."
Amen. Amen.
You want to see power? Look into, when you wake up in the morning, look at yourself in the mirror. After all the trials we've been through, you are still here.
Amen.
After all the disappointments you've been through, you are still here. If you want a miracle, you are the first miracle you can point.
Amen. Amen.
When they go to Jericho, then God told Joshua,
"Now
the ark shouldn't be in front. Now let the ark come to the middle, somewhere in between. The Levites should now lead, and let the ark follow the Levites." Then God elected seven church messengers, seven priests. In every age, or in every day, they go around the city once. Don't think that Jericho is some small, maybe a house like this, and no. It was a whole city. A whole city. And they have to go around it. Once a day. Remember, in silence. God works in the silence. If you don't see anything happening, that doesn't mean God is not working. God works in the silence. Even in the silence, there is a mystery.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. Amen. What was God doing at that time? As the ark was going around Jericho, the defenses and the walls of Jericho were being weakened from within. So on the seventh day, when they went around seven times, and the trumpets went off, by a mere shout, walls came down.
Amen.
Now, let us be a bit humanistic about this. By a shout, walls came down. In what world does this make sense? By a shout. That is why when you come to church, you shouldn't be sitting down there as and be pushed. No. When you have been told to be silent, be silent. When you have been told to shout, shout. God works at both ends of the line.
Amen.
The ark was in position.
Now,
hallelujah.
Amen.
It reminds me of Jehoshaphat.
Amen.
As he was going to battle with, against the Moabites. And all he could do was to just sing praises. The ark was leading them. And you were just singing praises. And you were just singing praises. You too, you can sing praises in the midst of your trial.
Amen.
Not every problem warrants a complaint. Not every trial warrants a murmuring. If God says, hold your peace, hold your peace. If God said, rejoice in your trial, rejoice. If you are supposed to rejoice and you hold your peace, God will raise up rocks to cry out in your steps. I don't think any of us want to be seated here for crocodiles to start coming, start to stand here and testify to us. That will be the biggest indictment to the human race.
Amen.
If human beings will not praise God, and animals will not praise God, and plants will not praise God, and the sea too will not praise God, stones will praise God.
Amen.
If the somebodies will not preach the message, God will raise up young men to preach the message.
Amen.
And I don't think any of you want to stand there for a bird to come and sing. And while Joseph was just singing,
singing,
praising the Lord. What did the Lord do? The Lord ambushed the Moabites and killed them from behind. By the time the worship service was over, the enemies were dead behind them. Praise the Lord in your trials.
Amen. Amen.
Just praise Him.
Amen.
Don't be weary. Sometimes you come to church and you want to praise, but you feel there's a very pressure on you. Let loose tonight. Let loose tonight.
Amen.
The prophet said that we take your minds off the things on the earth. Have the faith of an astronaut. Have the faith of an astronaut. And break through a place where all things are possible.
Amen.
One day David could not hold the excitement.
David,
the ark of the Lord had been in captivity. And it seems that sometimes it seems that the word of God is being defeated. Sometimes you see that the promise is being defeated. Don't lose faith in that
sister.
Don't lose faith in that sister. The prophet said, just when the word is just up, it seems the word is about to be defeated. In the message, the evening messenger, he said, when it just seems the message is about to defeat it, just when the messenger is about to be defeated, then God steps in. So while you think you are on the brink, hold on. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hold on, somebody.
Amen.
The Philistines did not value the ark.
The
word of God is nonsensical to the world. Paul said the preaching of the cross is foolishness unto those who are perishing. But to you who are saved, it is the power of God.
Amen.
And they were crazy enough, you see. God doesn't do his things anyhow.
Amen.
When God allowed the act to be taken, God can take care of himself. And the Philistines were, excuse my language, stupid enough. They didn't value, they didn't even know what it was. All they knew was it was a treasured property of Israel. And they went to place it in the room of their God.
And what you could see, one boss of them.
Overnight, then you see the head of this God has fallen down. It did not ring a bell to anybody. Then whoever lifted up the head and placed it back and put super glue around it.
Now, what's out of fire trade? You could see, Subian was a soil.
The next night, you see that the image has come down right to the knees.
Amen. Then
there were sicknesses moving in the midst of the people. The presence of God in Israel was a blessing to them.
Amen.
It was a curse to those outside.
Amen.
It was smashed to powder.
Amen. No, we're prone.
Put your problems in front of the ark tonight.
Amen.
Oh, I said, put your problems in front of the ark.
Amen.
And leave it there. Don't leave it in front of the ark and stand by and watch to see something. When you are standing there to see something, it will not happen. Leave it there and go home.
Amen.
And be in expectation that either a day by this time, or a week by this time, or a year by this time, you will receive answers.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The prophet tells us in the message, hear ye him, he says, the ark of the covenant is Jesus Christ. And the position of the ark was in the temple.
Now,
amen. In the holiest of holiest. And Paul tells us in 1 Corinthians 6:19 that you are the temple of God.
Amen.
So if Christ is the ark, and you are the temple, and the position of the ark is in the temple, the position of Christ is in you.
Amen.
You are of God. You are not of yourselves. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
The ark is supposed to be in the inner course of the believer. In the soul of the believer. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
The ark is not in Solomon's temple. The ark of the covenant is in the heart of the believer.
Amen.
Christ should not be in the outer court standing there looking outside. No. Christ should not be in your outer court in your flesh. Where you can come to church and jump and scream and shout and do everything. But the word has still not convicted you. Or Christ should not be in the second court, in the second room, in the second court.
Amen. Now Christ also on my metna as if you are done your toss me no more. Eh, you come be a honor.
Where he can, you can have all the scriptures and all the quotes, but it doesn't make any difference to you.
I wouldn't trust a moon, some in answer to me.
You he should be in the third chamber. The holiest of holiest. The bedroom where you can have intimate relationships. I always say we are not in a friendship with Christ. We are in a relationship. We have a marriage covenant. So your husband, you don't talk sweet things to your husband outside.
Amen.
You take him to the bedroom.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, praise the Lord, somebody. The Holy Ghost in your soul. Changing the very atoms of your body. What do you think happened to Sarah?
And then how do you say to Sarah?
Even when she was barren. Even in her oldest age, scripture says she was changed. Her body was changed. If you are barren, your body will be changed. If you are unemployed, your situation can be changed. Oh, praise the Lord, somebody.
Amen.
The ark finds its place. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The children of Israel, had the physical ark.
No,
that was made with hands.
But
we have an ark that was not made with hands. That cannot be seen by the naked eye. But it lives in us, making intercession for us. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
We have an eternal ark. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
The earthly ark was hidden in the temple.
I know what is. I saw them.
Only Levites and the high priest could go there. But this time, our ark, we can boldly enter and go and see the ark.
Amen.
It was death to go inside.
Amen.
But now, it is death to stay outside.
Amen. Amen.
The only the sanctified priest was the only person who
before
the ark. But we too.
Amen.
But we too. We have been made kings and priests.
Amen. Yes, why are here a software?
Amen. We have been sanctified on Calvary.
What so yeah, who are Calvary?
So now we are not the priest enters in with fear.
Amen. Or something they know or remember no so.
They have to go. Very carefully.
Amen.
The least mistake, you die. But this time, you are supposed to enter boldly. If you stay out, you die.
Amen.
The ark is in position.
Amen.
Christ is in position.
Christo, amen.
The ark is not tucked away in Israel, no.
Amen. Israel.
It sits right there in you.
Amen. They say there to mupe.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
The ark is right there in you.
Amen
and amen. Amen and amen.
Amen.
And when the ark was with Israel, they won almost all their battles.
Amen.
And that can be said about the spiritual Israel.
Amen.
After all the trials you have been through, here you are on a Wednesday evening. You did not sleep at home. You did not decide to do something at home. But you have come to church proclaiming the liberty God has given you. If you were not consumed then, you cannot be consumed now.
Amen.
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 He says, I am the Lord thy God, I change not. Therefore, ye sons of Israel are not to be consumed.
Amen.
We are not slaves to fear.
Amen.
We can now enter boldly.
Amen.
And approach the acquisitions.
Amen.
We cannot enter boldly. We cannot enter boldly into the presence of God. When I see the blood, I'll pass over you. We cannot enter boldly into the ark.
He is here to make intercession for you. The ark is in this place. You are at the right place. What you have to do right now is to enter boldly into his presence. Whatever you have need of, whatever you have need of, God cares about the minute details in your life.
Amen.
Christ our Redeemer died on the cross.
Amen.
Don't go far.
Amen.
Don't go far.
Amen.
He is right next to you.
Amen.
Enter into the temple.
Amen.
Enter into the holiest of holiest.
Amen.
Enter into his presence tonight.
Amen.
He is here to give you liberty.
Amen.
He is here to give you freedom.
Amen.
He is here to open doors for you.
Amen.
He is here to break walls.
Amen.
He is here to open wombs.
Amen.
He is here to provide employment.
Amen.
He is here to give the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Enter into the presence of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
When I see
blood,
let's be on our feet, church.
When I see
the blood, hallelujah. Christ our Redeemer,
I don't approve, die for the sinner, pay his due, sprinkle your soul with the blood of the Lamb, and I will pass, I will pass.
When I see the blood, hallelujah. Continues. Just begin to pray at this time.
Amen.
The ark is in position. So call on the owner of the ark. Approach the mercy seat this evening and begin to make your petition to the Lord. Don't hold back tonight. Don't hold back tonight. Give your all to the Lord tonight. All you have to say, give it to Him tonight. He is not too busy to hear your heart cry.
Pass
me not, O gentle Savior. Oh, my. Let your positions be known to Him tonight.
Oh,
Hallelujah,
to the Lord in prayer. I want to live like Jesus. I want the ark to change the very atoms of my body. The ark I possess within me. It should change the body, the very body I possess. That I would walk out there and people will see Christ. Not seeing me. Not seeing you. But seeing Jesus. That we should be living epistles.
Amen.
We should be able to find time for God. Being able to read the word. Begin to study the word. Listen to a tape or two. Encourage somebody in the Lord. Let's begin to talk to the Lord. I want to be like Jesus. To be like Jesus. To be like Jesus. Oh, on earth I long
to be like you. Let's all be on our feet. To be one of our Lord. One of our Lord. One of our Lord.
To be like
Jesus.
Sister, as we take the last prayer, Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you. We've come to your presence where the ark has been opened to us. We come to your presence where the veil has been rent, that we should come to your presence with boldness. So Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, tonight we are coming to you with our issues, be it marital issues, be it issues of birth, be it issues of employment, be it issues of our businesses, be it issues of our schooling, be it issues of our Christian walk. Lord Jesus, you being the Ark of the Covenant with Aaron's rod within you, Father, causing growth to dead things. Tonight, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, any dead womb, any dead marriage, any dead situation, we are speaking life tonight. Sicknesses that have gained root, we uproot those sicknesses in Jesus' name. Christian walks that seem to be dilly-dallying around, don't seem to know where he's going, being blown by every wind. Today, we plant ourselves by the rivers of waters and we say we shall not be moved. You who watches over Israel, you are watching over your word to perform it. Perfect anything that concerns your children today. Families are in your hands. Any attempt by the enemy to break any family, we rebuke the enemy in the name of Jesus. People who are bound by any problems, this is the acceptable year of the Lord. We proclaim a jubilee this evening because the ark has returned to its position. So let the earth rejoice. Let the children of God be rejoiced. Let the hearts of the children be gladdened. Promote the businesses of your children. Give the Holy Ghost in abundance to your children. Eternal life trust is in your care. You have planted us here for the sole purpose of being a lighthouse. So Lord Jesus, let us shine to this community. Amen. Let us shine to the world. Amen. We're committing the Levites in this house, from the head Levite to those who are following, and to the congregation and the laity. Lord, perfect anything that concerns your children. We are not leaving your presence, oh God. The very God who protected his ark right from the camp of the Philistines back into Jerusalem, carry us home on eagle wings. Bless our homes. Bless our families. Bless our businesses. Bless our friends. And let everyone be blessed. Eternal life trust is in your care. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, just as you built the temple of Solomon, built the eternal life temple, oh God. Raise up men and women who are giants in your word, who will not give breathing space to the enemy. Let the people of eternal life trust be a threat to the enemy of the to the camp of the enemy. Thank you for your word that has come. The ark in position. We bless your holy name. Lord, we are praying. We want to pray for our sister Alexandra Priot. Father, you've given her a bouncy baby just recently, but she seems to be still bleeding. Father, just like you stopped the blood flowing from the woman with the issue of blood, let me stop the blood flow right now. Father, we're praying for the believers in Israel who are waiting to be called up into the military. Father, we are praying, oh God, for the brother Shmuel and the rest. Lord Jesus, protect them, oh God. Even in this conflict they found themselves in. And let there be peace in their land so they can have the liberty to worship God. So, Father, as we are praying for peace in Israel, Father, let there be peace in the camp of the bride, that we can be also have liberty to praise you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we bless your holy name, O God. Have preeminence in our lives. And let your name be praised forevermore. Amen. Amen. God richly bless you all. God richly bless you all. Amen.
Amen.
Take the name of Jesus with you. O child of sorrow and of woe. Let's take our offering, please. It will joy and comfort give if you take it wherever you go. Precious name. Oh, how sweet. Oh, how sweet. Oh, prophet, and joy of heaven, precious name. Oh, how sweet. Oh, prophet, and joy of heaven. Oh, precious name.
Precious name.
Precious name.
Oh, how sweet.
Oh, above heaven. Hope of heaven,
precious name,
precious name.
Oh, how
sweet.
Hope of heaven.
Oh, why don't you hold to God's unchanging hand?
Build your hopes on
Titi.
Oh,
richly bless you. God bless you. So God willing, we'll be meeting here on Sunday. And Friday, the youth, we are meeting. So let's please make it a point to be here.
Oh, yeah, me ba.
Ye ji wa ya uye bi ya uye ba mi te. God will bless you.
I'm in Jaya.
Hold to God.